In 2010, I moved to Florida from Birmingham, Alabama, just after the oil spill in the Gulf, and nobody wanted real estate. Today, what was selling for $25,000 a lot, the houses are going for $700,000 plus. Which then makes you ask, when is the best time to buy and sell? Well, in this area where housing prices are spiking, and this home, which was the first home to be built in this neighborhood for probably $200,000, $300,000, today that home has doubled and in some cases tripled. Which once again, you've got to ask, when is the best time to buy and when is the best time to sell? Real estate is at all-time highs in sales. Since the beginning of 2020, real estate has gone up 19.1%. It's an insane amount of growth in 1 year. It reminds me of the whole housing boom back during the 01 to 06 era. Gotta flip my head around so you can see my eyes. But real estate has exploded. If you bought land 5 years ago, even 2 years ago, you have made money on that land. And my question is, because housing has gone up so much and there is a major shortage of land available to build new homes, what is the best purchase right now to enter into? Is it the stock market, the housing market, or the land market? Unfortunately, I don't think any of them are the good time to buy. Housing market has skyrocketed so much. I mean, parabolic moves. And we all know after parabolic moves come parabolic crashes. That may be delayed because interest rates are so darn cheap. Federal Reserve has no problem holding interest rates at all-time lows. I mean, we could even see a zero interest rates or negative rates on the 10-year and short-term treasuries. So, do you buy land today? During the housing crisis, we saw a lot of areas like this where the neighborhoods were built out, but the homes were never built. And because of the housing crisis, a lot of these developers went bankrupt. Well, back around 2011 or so, 2010, 2011, D.R. Horton came in and started scooping up these neighborhoods, buying these lots for anywhere from a $9,000 to $20,000 a lot, super dirt cheap. 2015 rolls around, we're looking for a new home, and we're like, we'll buy a house here, live in it for 2 years, and flip it. This was one of the neighborhoods we looked at. These homes at the time we were looking in 2015 were selling for about $190,000 to $225,000, depending on upgrades and all that kind of thing. Today, these houses are selling for $438,000 to $500,000. And I promise you, they ain't worth $500,000. It's supply and demand. And right now, what I'm seeing is housing markets in Tennessee, Florida, anywhere where you got tax-free, tax-free states, state income taxes free, you're seeing an explosion in those areas. Austin area, Nevada, Las Vegas areas, all these housing prices are going through the roof. And I'm hearing more and more people talk about buying real estate. The real estate that is really in demand, and you see it with Toll Brothers, you see it with the D.R. Hortons of the world, is land. They have run out of land. The rumor is here on the panhandle, D.R. Horton is now buying single lots instead of full-on neighborhoods where they can develop a 50 to couple hundred home development because there is no lots to develop. And so now they're looking for single lots or couple homes they can build on because there is no land. One thing God is not creating any more of is land, and what the earth is doing is taking that land away. So I look at this housing explosion and I ask the question, if you have no more land to build, and the companies that build massive land or massive home housing developments have no land to build on, how do they keep going up in price? I am naturally a contrarian. I look at things and question why. Why is that worth what it is? When I look at the stock market today, I question why. Why is this worth this much? Why is Tesla worth 1,100 times price to earnings? Why is NIO, who makes no money, who has no exposure to the US markets at this point in time, worth more than it was, way more than it was in May? So when I look at the housing market, and I look at the mass manufacturers of homes like D.R. Horton and Toll Brothers, the one thing they're running out of is the land element. And when you don't have land, how do you build? Toll Brothers in the Wall Street Journal this morning, Saturday the 26th, day after Christmas, hope you had a Merry Christmas, said that this month they're only selling 15 to 20% of their neighborhoods. They wouldn't allow their salespeople to sell any more than that. Well, what are they trying to do? Stretch their earnings. Why are they doing that? They don't have any land to build on. I heard this real estate pro, global holder of commercial real estate, make the comment, the best time to buy is when interest rates are high and there are more sellers than buyers. Where are we at today? We're in an environment where interest rates are at all-time lows, where you can get a 15-year mortgage or a 30-year mortgage that is less than 3% annually interest. You are seeing all-time highs in prices, especially your states that are tax-free, state tax-free, are exploding. The Tennessees, the Nashvilles, the Floridas, the area where I'm at. And I look at this and I go, is this the time to buy? Could this go on? I hear it from real estate agents all the time. Oh, this is going to keep going on. Well, I heard that in 06 also. And then I didn't hear it for 2-3 years. It ended and abruptly wiped out enormous amount of wealth. My point of this is there is a time to buy and there is a time to sell. And when you apply a formula to this and you take your emotions out of your investing, things change. You see the world differently. And right now, I'm looking at the housing market and I'm picking my entries and I'm looking at, where do I buy? Will I buy land? If I buy land, at what point do I buy that land? Today, for me, it's not time. I believe there will be greater opportunities in the near future when it comes to housing, and specifically housing stocks.